Hey everyone, Arik here from Cycle Maintenance Academy. Did you know that it is possible to service a Shimano dynamo hub? If you don't believe me, then let me prove it. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to service a Shimano dynamo hub using only a few basic bike maintenance tools. Okay, let's begin. Tools required: 15 and 17mm spanners, 17mm cone spanner, 36mm headset spanner, small, thin flat head screwdriver or pin, magnetic pickup tool, pair of pliers, the greaser, isopropyl alcohol or electrical contact cleaner, cloth or paper towel. Preparation. Before you start working on your dynamo hub, make sure to take off the wheel, and if required, a disc rotor or roller brake. If you're unsure about how to do this, you can check out my video tutorials here. You can also find links to these videos in the description below. Place the wheel on the ground and spin the axle to sense the resistance. This drag might feel a bit like the bearings are too tight, but that's normal. Remember the level of this resistance, because it will be useful when you tighten the cones on the axle later on. Servicing the left-hand side bearings and cleaning the armature. Place the wheel on a bench so that you can work on the non-drive side. Remove the wheel nut and washer. Use a 17mm cone spanner to grip the cone and another 17mm spanner to loose the lock nut anti-clockwise. Remove the lock nut and spacer. Use the 17mm cone spanner to loosen the cone and unscrew it by hand. Use a magnetic tool to grab all the 12 bearings from the cup. Now turn the wheel so that you can work on the drive side. Use a 36mm headset spanner to loosen the armature cover by turning it anti-clockwise. Take out the axle and armature from the hub shell and set them aside. Clean the magnets in the hub wheel using isopropyl alcohol and a cloth. Spray isopropyl alcohol on a cloth and wipe down the armature. Using a degreaser and a cloth, clean the bearings, the cone, and the bearing cup. Slide the armature and axle back into the hub. Tighten the armature cover by turning it clockwise until it's secure. Apply grease to the cup and put the bearings back in. Screw in the cone until it touches the bearings. Put back the spacer and the lock nut. use the 17mm cone spanner to hold the cone in place and the 17mm spanner to tighten the lock nut clockwise. Check if the axle spins without any wobbling. If it feels too loose, use the 17mm cone spanner to hold the cone in place and the 17mm spanner to loosen the lock nut anti-clockwise. Now turn the cone spanner clockwise quarter of a turn and tighten the lock nut. If it feels too loose, use the 17mm cone spanner to hold the cone in place and the 17mm spanner to loosen the lock nut anti-clockwise. Now turn the cone spanner anti-clockwise quarter of a turn and tighten the lock nut. Finally, refit the washer and the wheel nut. Servicing the right-hand side bearings. Remove the wheel nut and the washer. While holding the connection terminal, release the lock nut anti-clockwise with a 17mm spanner. Remove the lock nut . Use a small flathead screwdriver or a pin to lift off the frame connection terminal plate from the terminal. Remove the plastic spacer. The lamp connection terminal plate is wired and might be glued to the terminal. Before removal, gently break the glue. And lift off the plate, being careful not to damage the wire. Lift the outer plastic bit of the terminal and guide the lamp connection terminal plate through the hole in that part. Slide the inner part of the terminal with a pointy end and the metal plate of the axle. There's a groove in the axle. Guide the wire into this groove. Use a 17mm cone spanner to undo the right-hand side cone. Unscrew it enough to gain clear access to the bearing cup without damaging the terminal plate. Use a magnetic pickup tool to remove all the bearings from the bearing cup. Use a degreaser and a cloth to clean the bearings, the cone and the bearing cup. Apply grease to the bearing cup and reinstall the bearings. Screw the cone onto the axle until it touches the bearings. Refit the metal plate so that the little tab is pointing away from the wheel and the pointy side of the hole fits over the terminal plate. Slightly bend the wire and insert the pointed inner section of the terminal ensuring that the groove on this part is on the wheel side. This will create a small gap between the inner part of the terminal and the wire. As you place the outer plastic section of the terminal onto the inner section, carefully pass the lamp connection terminal through the hole in that outer terminal section. Gently press the lamp connection terminal plate in the slot on the right side of the terminal arm and put the plastic spacer over it in the correct orientation. Place the frame connection terminal plate so that the long end fits in a groove on the left side of the terminal arm. Screw the lock nut onto the axle clockwise until it reaches the terminal. You may find it helpful to use your other hand to secure the frame connection terminal plate in position. While holding the terminal, tighten the lock nut to 17mm spanner. Put back the washer and the wheel nut.
Thanks for staying with me all the way to the end, and don't forget to let me know in the comments below whether you liked the video and how you got on servicing your dynamo hub. If you want to support my channel, then consider a small donation by clicking on the Super Thanks button below this video. Thanks, and see you soon!